Good morning, student. Today we are discussing about impact test in strength of materials laboratory. So this is your impact testing machine. So under the impact testing machine, we have two experiments. One is high jaw impact test. The other one is the Charpy impact test. It is. So today we are discussing about Charpy impact test. Okay, so before going to do the experiment, first we have to prepare the specimen. Okay, so we will discuss about this. So what is the aim of this experiment? Okay, so the aim of this experiment is to determine the toughness of the specimen. To determine this toughness of the specimen it is. Okay, and this is your specimen. Mostly for Charpy impact test, the specimen should be 55 mm length, 55 mm length, whereas the width and the depth of the specimen is 10 mm it is. Okay, length of the specimen is 55 mm, the width and depth of the specimen is 10 mm it is. Okay, and the area of cross section is 10 into 10, 100 mm square you will get, right? So in this 55 mm length, in the middle of the specimen, you have to cut the specimen 2 mm deep. You have to cut the specimen 2 mm deep and make a V shape. Okay? Right? Next, so we'll go for the precautions of this Charpy impact test. Okay, so before going for the precautions, let us will discuss about the apparatus. So one apparatus we have completed, specimen which is 55 mm length and width and depth is 10 mm it is, and we have cut this 2 mm deep in the middle of the specimen and made a V shape. Okay, so apparatus are, we have a hammer. Okay, so here we have a safety lock. Safety lock we have it is, right? And we have a dial reading. Okay, so the outer reading is Charpy reading it is. The outer dial reading it is of a Charpy. So observe here, 1 division is equal to 2 joules it is. This is very important. 1 division is equal to 2 joules. So whereas inner reading it is of eye jaw readings. Okay, so here also same, you have to take while calculating, 1 division equal to 2 joules it is. Okay, so for the Charpy impact test, the angle of hammer drop should be 140 degrees. From 140 degrees it is. So whereas for eye jaw impact test, so the angle of drop hammer should be 90 degrees. From 90 degrees we have to release the hammer it is. Okay, then we'll do this experiment first. Okay, so before doing this experiment, we have to test the dial reading. Okay, we will release the rammer. Okay, so that the dial reading should come to 0. So that is R1, initial reading R1 equal to 0 it is. Next, R2 means we'll place the specimen, okay, horizontally we'll place the specimen. Okay, next we'll release the pendulum so that the pendulum will strike the specimen. So the amount of energy observed by the specimen, so that we can know from the dial readings. So how many joules of energy that was observed by the specimen it is. Okay, let us start to do the experiment. So first reading is R1, that is initial reading, means we have to release the normal pendulum without placing the specimen it is. Okay, so first we have to remove the safety guard. Right, so after removing the safety guard, okay, then release the pendulum, a normal pendulum. Okay, so and apply the brakes to stop the pendulum. right? So now the reading of initial reading R1 is 0 without placing a specimen. Again, you have to fix your pendulum at 140 degrees. Because we are doing this Charpy test, you have to place the this hammer at 140 degrees. Whereas in Izod, it is of 90 degrees. You have to place our pendulum in 90 degrees. Okay. So now we will place the specimen. Okay. So this cutted end should be opposite direction of the pendulum. It is okay. We are placing this specimen horizontally. Horizontally, and what we have cutted in the middle of the specimen, so that should be opposite to the pendulum. It is okay, and make it this 2 downward direction, so that then after that we'll take this safety guard. We'll take out this safety guard. Okay, if you release this lever, this will strike the specimen, and here we can know that. So what is the amount of energy that was observed by the specimen in joules? You will get the reading in the dial gauge. It is, so I am releasing the pendulum to strike the specimen. It is okay, right? So automatically you apply the brake to stop the okay. So what is the energy observed is, so here it is of 50, 52, 54 joules of energy observed by the specimen. It is okay. See, here it is of braked off. So for this, see, earlier the specimen was like this. Okay, earlier the specimen was like this. So now after striking, so it has braked. For this, the energy observed by the specimen, okay, so the reading is 54 joules it is. Okay, 54 joules it is. Okay, then we will go for the calculations. Right? So as we have discussed earlier before doing the experiment, so length of the specimen is 55 mm, breadth is of 10, and depth also it is of 10 mm it is. Okay, so you can see here the cross section of your specimen. Okay, and the I told you that Charpy impact test, so the angle of drop of a hammer, it is of 140 degrees. So for Izod impact test, the angle of drop will be 90 degrees it is. Okay, next, what is the hammer weight? It is of 5 kg hammer weight we have, right? So SN number 1, so what is the area of the specimen? So this specimen area, it is of 10 into 10, it is of 100 mm square it is. Okay, next, what is the impact in joules energy observed? Okay, so when the hammer is struck the specimen, okay, so what is the joules observed? It is 54 joules it is. Okay, so what is the impact strength I in joules per mm square? So where the formula I equal to J by A it is. I equal to J by A. So what is, here you can write I equal to J by A it is. Okay, so what is J? J is 54. So 54 by 100 it is. Okay, so we'll get I equal to 0.54 Newton per joules per mm square it is. Okay, so that is the end of experiment.